It's time to put on our thinking caps and interpret the significance of what we've been exploring. Unless it explains, history is trivial. Did you find much this week that needs to be explained? As you explored science in the Roman Empire, you encountered different, sometimes contradictory, explanations. Interpretations have varied over time and continue to be disputed even today. For example, the following caricatures of Roman-era science are unfortunately widespread. First, Roman scientific endeavor represented a sudden decline and major loss of the impetus of Hellenistic science because Romans were more interested in ethical philosophy than inquiry into the causes of things. Or take a second caricature. The suffocating authority of Aristotle's cosmology, which was virtually unquestioned during the Roman Empire, stifled the growth of science in Latin Europe. Or third, the rise of Christianity and the decline of ancient science go hand in hand because of the Christian impulse to attribute everything to God and consequently to ignore or even suppress investigation of natural causes. Or a fourth, Galen's medical theories doomed the history of medicine in later centuries to an endless series of fruitless speculations based not on firsthand anatomical experience, so much as on hearsay and the authority of others. Have you encountered these interpretations before? Although any statement might contain a kernel of truth, none of these claims is now accepted by scholars. How would you respond to caricatures like these? How did these caricatures arise? In view of such misconceptions, what steps might we take to ensure that our interpretations are warranted and not merely subjective speculations? How might we minimize our inherent human tendencies toward presentism and rational reconstruction? Two of the large-scale cultural contexts for science in the Roman Empire are the legacy of Roman law and the emergence of Christianity as a major world religion. With respect to Christianity, what were the most important implications of theistic perspectives for understanding what is nature and how is nature known? How do the writings of Basil, Philoponus, and Augustine exemplify a Christian theistic scientific tradition? With respect to the legacy of Roman law, how would you respond to a friend who says something like this? One of the most important contributions of the Roman Empire to civilization was the legacy of Roman law and ethical thought. In the case of science, it is the same. The legacy of Roman law contributed to the scientific tradition. Roman-era natural philosophers, from Galen to Cicero to Basil to Boethius, and even Roman encyclopedists, from Pliny to Isidore, bequeathed to later cultures a profound confidence in the lawful order of nature, the idea that nature is governed not by chance, but by intelligible, unalterable natural laws. The only exceptions to this rule, such as Lucretius, found few followers in this period. Would you agree? How significant was Roman-era science? What is your interpretation?